live here. I've got to head over to the other building to get everything up and running, but we are streaming now.
Mm-hmm. From your...
Yeah.
Oh, from this camera?
Yeah.
Oh.
Both of them were working. But yeah, I could not get our audio into this.
So audio is coming through those mics?
Yeah.
Okay.
Nice. Okay. But yeah, I gotta head over to the building, send the live stream to them.
Okay.
And I'll back in a couple minutes. Yep, I got no time.
You got my number if you need anything?
Yep. I've got that recording and I've got the application recording. Yep.
Thank you.
Stand there talking for you.
So I realized something on the way over here. So if I'm getting audio from that mic, which I know I am, that's...
Is that what I used to
do?
Huh? Yeah, that's what I used to
do.
But you can see I am sending.
Okay, I'm just going to check with, make sure they're all ready, and I'll come back and tell you.
Okay.
Okay, and then Alana, you'll hear.
You know. Nell, please come forward and lead us in the singing of our national anthem.
Who can it touch? Our home and native land, true patriot love, in all thy sons command, with glowing hearts we see thee rise, our true north strong and from far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Thank you, Lord. And I thank you. Good afternoon, students, dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Chris Lowy, the Dean of Trades, Agriculture, and Environment, the principal of our Fairview campus. Before we proceed today with today's milestone, I'd like to remind everyone to turn off the cell phone, any other electronic devices that might disturb the proceedings. And thank you. On behalf of the college, I'd like to acknowledge that we are meeting on traditional territory of the Treaty 8. Today's ceremony takes place on traditional Beaver land in the Cree territory. I would also like to recognize the land of the Métis. It gives me great pleasure to be your Master of Ceremonies as we join to celebrate the successes of our students graduating from our Fairview campus. Our graduates have worked hard, studied hard, build academic credentials and develop career skills. Today, they join the ranks of over 140,000 alumni who've turned to GPRC to improve their education and their lives. Graduates, on behalf of everyone here, I wish you ongoing success in your life beyond Grand Prairie Regional College at this point. I'd like to begin today's ceremony with the introduction of our guest dignitaries. I ask each to rise in acknowledgement and we'll hold off applause until the last name is called. Representing the MD of Fairview, we have Reeve Peggy Johnson. Representing the MD of Peace, number 135, we have Deputy Reeve Sandra Easton. Representing the town of Fairview, we have Town Councillor Riley Parker. Representing the Grand Prairie Roman Catholic Separate School District, we're honored to have Superintendent Harold Garman. Representing Industry Programs and Standards Advanced Education, we have Training Officer John Tran. We also have quite a number of dignitaries joining us here today from Grand Prairie Regional College. Board of Governors include the Board of Governors Chair, Natalia Reimer, Nan Bartlett, Gord Pellerin, Lori Knock, Jane Manning, Student Association President Blaine Badouk, and
graduate, as they go from here, this would be a springboard for them to continue to press forward and to achieve. So we just want to pray for your blessing upon them. Continue to bless the rest of the ceremonies this afternoon as well. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Dave. I'd now like to ask Natalia Reimer to please step forward and bring greetings on behalf of the board.
Okay, let's get your shoes, guys.
Thank you. And welcome to all students, all faculty, family, friends, community members, and dignitaries. This is always a great day, and really brings to light why we as a board of governors do exactly what we do. And it's for these days, it's for the students. On behalf of the Grand Prairie Regional College Board of Governors, I'm very proud to honor you, the graduating students of Fairview. The Board of Governors are proud to be the stewards of a comprehensive community institution, providing post-secondary education for learners throughout our region. We are very excited about the future of GPRC and the expansion of GPRC as well as providing degree and status. This will only build on more than a 65-year tradition of excellence in post-secondary education in Fairview, of which you are now all part of. GPRC has a reputation for excellent faculty and great leadership, so I know your experience here is a good one that is top quality. You all now have the opportunity to take what you've learned here and be leaders in your community and in your professions. This is the well-worn path of all of our GPRC grads. We know this because our community and industry leaders tell us regularly how vital GPRC is to our region's success and to the future. You are now a part of that success and that future. All of us on the board can't wait to see how you go out and how you contribute positive development to each of your communities and enrich the places that you call home. I'm going to bring the words from a past chair, Pete Hello, for your consideration, and that's to consider volunteering. Volunteerism is enriching, and it's also instrumental in community engagement, personal, professional, and community development. Our board believes strongly in contribution to one's community, and each one of us embraces and encourages volunteerism. We wish that you also believe that volunteerism is instrumental to the development and growth for yourself and for your communities as you move forward. Thank you again for choosing GPRC, and congratulations for all that you have accomplished to be a member of today's graduating class. The Board of Governors and Grand Prairie Regional College offer and extend each of you the very best wishes in the future, which is definitely going to be a bright one. Congratulations again, students.
Thank you, Natalia. I'd ask Students Association President Lane Bidoux, would you please step forward and bring greetings on behalf of the Students Association.
Thank you. Good afternoon. It is great to be back in Fairview today, especially for such a memorable day. On behalf of myself and the entire representative council of the Students Association, let me begin by saying congratulations to all of you, the students. It has been an honor to serve you over this past year. Together with your student counselors, you elected, we have accomplished a great deal. Since the beginning of our term, we have been very intentional in our focus on improving student life on the Fairview campus. As your president, I can say with confidence that the results of these accomplishments have made not just this year, but will have an immediate and long-term impact on student life. Specifically for our Fairview campus, we received an increase in mental health funding, including allocated resources coming soon to the Fairview campus. We strengthened student engagement and listened purposefully to your needs and process, ensured they were addressed in our processes. And we reopened and improved Notley Square, letting students an affordable and friendly lounge space to play pool, eat, have a few minutes, and socialize together. and the people who deserve the credit are the reason we are here today. You, the students of GPLC Fairview Campus. Okay. I would like to also recognize three special students here who are graduating today. Alyssa Kahn, Heather Tamiki, and Lil Clark, your student counselors. This past year, they were vital in ensuring that the Fairview campus was represented in the SSA. They did a great job, and we'd like to send some extra special congratulations to those successes today. Students, today is your day. You work hard, you've put on nighters, and hopefully you've had fun while doing it. Now we have to celebrate you and all the efforts you've put in. But as you know, success is never achieved alone. We all know that by working together, better is always possible. And in recognition of this fact, I would like to take a moment and thank the GPLC faculty and staff here today. Thank you for always putting our students first. Their accomplishments are your accomplishments. Just would also like to thank the parents and family in the room today. Thank you for supporting your loved ones in their educational endeavors. School is not easy, but nothing helps more than knowing that you have people in your life that will support you through the process. Students, today marks a new chapter in your life. Today you turn from GPLC student to GPLC alumni. As a student, you had a lot of responsibilities. And while you will no longer have to stay up all night studying for exams or finishing your assignments, you now have a new set of responsibilities as a GPLC alumni to represent our college and to take what you've learned here and take it with you during the next chapter of your life. As you leave this campus behind, my wish is that you take three things from your time at GPLC. Firstly, what you've learned in your courses and your program. That's why we're here in the first place, of course. Secondly, the friendships, the connections and memories you've made. These will enrich your life for years to come. Thirdly, your personality. What makes you, you? You are each a shining example of what makes GPLC and this entire region so great. Take what you learned here and bring it with you into the workforce and into everyday life. But even more importantly, bring you into what you do. Let your personality shine. Be proud of who you are and offer and everything you offer to the world. Each of you are unique, so make sure you put your own unique spin on everything you do in life. No two GPLC alumni success stories are the same. And today, I see many new success stories just waiting to be told. So go out and invite your success story. Go out and show a GPLC alumni on me.
Remember where you came from and those that helped you along the way. Never doubt yourselves. You are good. well prepared for the future. You can work with others for a common purpose to make things happen. You are a GPRC graduate. Best wishes from the ESA.
Let us now let Riley Parker please step forward and bring greetings on behalf of the town of Fairview.
Good afternoon. My name is Riley Parker Sitch, and on behalf of the mayor, council, staff, and residents of the town of Fairview, I would like to say congratulations to the graduating class of 2018 from the Fairview campus of GPRC. The town of Fairview is proud to be home to the college, and we thank you for choosing it to complete your post-secondary education. We wish you luck and success as you enter a new stage in your life. We hope you enjoyed copious amounts of pizza bread and found some time to take in a few Flyers games in between your studying course. Congrats again to all of you, and good luck in your future endeavors.
I applied to various schools to
tried to get into the fourth class parent training program, but was unsuccessful. I enrolled online and reduced my work hours to part-time. Upon my completion of my prac demo at the Shell Power Engineering Technology Center, encouraged by my success, I jumped back into furthering my education at GPRC. For many of us, this is an experience and a period of time in our lives that has made a great impact in shaping the individuals we are today and the individuals we pursue to be tomorrow. John Keats said, "Nothing becomes real till it is experienced." Each one of you has had a different experience that is unique to you. As I stand here today, I hope that all of you take the positives from your journey and share them with people that surround you. In college, many of us discovered, no matter how rich a textbook may be in knowledge, it takes a special individual to share the specific information with the rest of us. This person may be your teacher, your journeyman, or even a friend. The important thing is, we have all had someone in our life who has made us open up to be the best version of ourselves. As Benjamin Franklin said, "Tell me and I forget. Teach me and I remember. Involve me and I learn." Involvement is the basis of our educational journey. As a collective group in our tough-nosed placements within industry, we can only grow as a whole with the involvement and the inclusion of others around us. We have the opportunity to be involved in our education in order to be included within industry. Our educational experience isn't a one-man show. It takes all of us, students, teachers, the journeymen, and the industry as a whole, to perform together to become a well-oiled machine. If we have learned anything as humanity, it is strength in numbers. Take what you have learned to become part of the process. Be involved, not only for the advancement and growth of your workplace and your community, but also for you as an individual. Many of us are thankful for the patience and the perseverance of the ones closest to us. This may be your mother, your father, your spouse, or even your kids. They've been part of the process just as much as you have. As I'm sure they are proud of you, I am too. Nobody said it was easy to be an animal health tech, a Harley Davidson tech, maybe a fin and cap tech, or attain your journeyman status as a plumber, a welder, a carpenter, a steam and pipe fitter, a heavy equipment, automotive, or motorcycle mechanic. Maybe you got your certificate as a power engineer, a motorcycle mechanic, or in parts and materials. However, you did it, and nobody can take that away from you. In conclusion, remember, as many of you will enter the working world, you'll be assigned a new apprentice, a new colleague to train, or a partner to work side by side. Remember how it felt to be inspired and led in the proper direction. Share every tip and trick that has helped you along the way. As you move forward, you will have the power to share your strengths with the individuals around you, making you a better teammate, a better friend, and most importantly, an irreplaceable employee. Thank you.
Achievements. Please, this is for students. This is for the accomplishments
of the students, the parents, the families. If you have to take an extra second or two to get that picture just right, it's all about you guys. It's not anything other than the students, and this is a time to celebrate that. During the presentation, students will be called upon by their programs and will file through the corridor behind the stage. They will come back on stage on the corridor of the stage right and walk individually across the stage when the name is called. And graduates, please remember, pause and smile. Okay? Handing out our scrolls and congratulating our graduates will be our president and CEO at GPRC, Mr. Don Matchick, our Board of Governors Chair, Natalia Reiner, and presenting the Alumni Foundation, the GPRC Alumni Foundation, will be VP External Relations, Carmen Hackstead. If I could ask those people to please join up on stage here. And as we work through any chairs and faculty that wish to congratulate graduates, are invited on stage as the program is announced. Again, family and friends are most welcome to come forward at any time to take pictures. However, we do not, we ask you to not impede the professional photographer we have here who's been retained for this occasion. You want to just give yourself a wave there? There you are. Thank you. So now what I'd like to do, will the students from the Animal Health Technology Diploma Program please stand and file backstage. And I would invite the faculty from the Animal Health Technology Diploma Program to please come forward on stage also. Thank you. petition.
Thank you.
Would the Think Big Service Technician Diploma Program please rise and exit to their right backstage? And I'd also like to at this time invite the program faculty to come forward.
Thank you.
I'd like to invite the faculty from the Motorcycle Mechanics Certificate program if they wish to come up on stage. Thank you. Engineering Third Class Certificate, Braden Berman. Braden thanks his parents for the fellow student services of Roxanne and Alana for making this year easier and stress-free. And I'd like to thank him for the inspirational words that he provided us today and some very thoughtful ideas coming from that young man. Parker Jeffrey.
Natalia and Carmen, if you
Don, I'd like you to stick around, if possible. And I will call upon Don Nadger, GPRC President and CEO, to deliver the President's message. Can you please step forward?
Thanks, Chris. Before I start, welcome, and thank you for being here to celebrate on a typical stormy Alberta day, and I appreciate you driving out and celebrating our wonderful apprentices and our students. Braden, where are you? Very inspirational words about obstacles and getting there. I'd be very proud of that, Braden. You did a wonderful job. I'm not going to be long here because I think these folks want to have some of that present food that's waiting for down the hall. Congratulations on your achievement and your dedication to college education. It takes a lot of work, and so congratulations. You have no idea how proud we are. It's your success that means our success. Our faculty, our staff, and all of those that support you, this is why we're here. And so thank you for that. You continue to amaze us with your accomplishments. I mean, the grades that we're seeing, the things that you do, you continue to amaze us. And we know that you're a vital part of our future here in Alberta, across the country, and around the world for that matter. You know, it's the success of the students that we've had over the years that helped us with our historical milestone last week, when the Minister of Advanced Education, Marlon Schmidt, gave us degree granting authority and allowed us to pursue university status. That's been more than 50 years, a 50-year dream with the Grand Prairie Regional College, 65-year dream with Fairview campus. And it's the student success that makes it easy just for us to achieve those kinds of levels. So I want to thank you. It's that leadership we hold that as you head out the door, that you take that leadership to a new level and become the new leaders. And you come back to our college, and you take our college to the next level, whatever that may be. We reassure this community that we will remain a comprehensive community institution. We will continue to offer and value trades, diplomas, and certificates as we start down the green path. Our trades and certificates and diplomas are essential to post-secondary education and to the employers of, region, the employers of this region. They are essential to driving the spirit of service in our region mentor institution. And we look forward to a very bright future at GPRC. To our graduates and your education and to this college, we know that we will mutually grow and evolve over the years, and we will continue to improve our communities and improve our society. Thank you for choosing GPRC. You had options, you chose GPRC. I think you chose the best college in the land. Thank you for choosing GPRC. And this is not the end of our relationship. As of today, you are GPRC alumni. We want you to stay with us. Stay in touch with us. Help us grow. Help us be better in the future. I wish you all the best as you go out and pursue your dreams. And so thank you and congratulations. As we say in Grand Prairie and in GPRC, and that is steps to the greater. Once a wolf, always a wolf. Thank you very much. An exciting time for our graduates. We are now just about through our ceremony. However, I don't want to miss a small but important detail. Each of you may now move your tassel on your mortarboard to the left side. Many staff and students have worked effectively and efficiently in putting
today's program. Thank you so much.
Thank you.